All right, so we're looking at the Lotka-Volterra model. That explain how predator and prey fluctuate around one another's populations. The prey population growth can be modeled by the equation dt, sorry, dn over dt is equal to r times n minus a times n times p. The predator can be modeled by the equation dp over dt is equal to f a n p minus q p. And here, population size is n for the prey, p for the predator. The intrinsic growth rate of the prey is r, its population size is n. A stands for the predator's per capita attack rate. So, how good it is at capturing the prey per unit of time. And P is the number of predator individuals in the population. For the predator, F represents a constant indicating the efficiency at converting the prey it has eaten into new predators. And Q is another constant, the mortality rate. All right. And so this should be capital P there. Let's just play with this and see what happens when we put the predators at zero here to the population growth of the prey. So dn over dt would equal rn minus the quantity a times n times zero. And so that would simplify to r times n minus zero. So we see that population exponential growth equation here, just like we've seen before. But here it's in reference to the prey. Let's do the same thing for the predator. So we have dp over dt is equal to f a n p minus q p. And here we're going to set n equal to zero. And when we do that, this equation becomes q over p. And this is very similar again to exponential growth, but in this case it's going to be negative since this is mortality and not birth.